Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Sorippers and Quincies alike, welcome to the Bleach Bros Soul Awards. Tonight we gather to celebrate the year 2023, which will go down as one of the better years for Bleach Bros Souls. With exciting remix and even more exciting new addition to the game, K-Lab did a great job this year bringing all the characters we know and love from the Bleach IP to game and making them more fun than ever. And with tonight's show, we have over 20 awards to give out, highlighting and celebrating some of the best and most memorable characters of the entire year. Whether it was for good or bad reasons, these characters made sure to leave their mark on the game. So without further ado, let's jump into the awards, starting off with the Best Premium Character Award. Because within the year 2023, we received a great set of premium characters. In fact, the year 2023 almost started with an amazing set of premium characters, that being a remake of a fan favorite anniversary character. And that went all because halfway through the year, we also did get two anniversary characters for the first time ever, Thousand Year Blood War themed, that also fall under the premium category. So our following six nominees should come at no surprise, as these are without doubt easily some of the best premium characters in the entire game. Here are your nominees for the Best Premium Character Award for the year 2023. White, 8th Anniversary Version. Ichigo, 8th Anniversary Version. Nelio, The Hidden Version. Tensa Zangetsu. Ichigo, Renewed Version. Ishin. And the winner for Best Premium Character of the Year goes to White, 8th Anniversary Version. Who would have thought that the anniversary would have been celebrated with White? A character to have their first addition to the game 8 years into the game's lifespan, and to have it as an anniversary character is absolutely crazy. But what was even crazier is how powerful this character was on release, and still is. Having Frenzy Plus 2 with 80% SP boost, an increased chance to inflict status amend with Lacerate and also Drain, this character is sure to hit very hard and also easily keep himself at full stamina. The mind attribute prior to 2023 was in a very bad state, and it was no surprise that the anniversary brought us a new powerful mind character, and a White was the exact character that we were looking for. He was not only a great addition to the game, but most importantly, a much needed addition to the mind attribute, making his presence even more impactful. It's no surprise that the anniversary always brings us amazing characters, and 8th Anniversary White is no exception. But that then leads us into our next award, the Best Limited Character Award, which, to be fair, is the more competitive awards. Since it's no surprise in any given year, limited characters are the ones that reign supreme. They are, after all, limited. And within the year 2023, we not only saw a set of new Thousand Year Bloodwood characters, we also got some really good seasonal characters, and also, most importantly, a surprisingly large amount of Burn the Witch characters. But with these great sets of limited characters, only one character can stand supreme with the award that is the Best Limited Character. So without further ado, let's have a look at the six nominees. Here are your nominees for the Best Limited Character Award for the year 2023. Ichigo, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 Version. Yuha Baha, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 Version. Ichibe, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 Version. Kilge, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 Version. Yachidu, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 Version. Macy, Burn the Witch Parasol Version. And the winner for Best Limited Character of the Year goes to Yuha Baha, 2024 Version.
Oh,
Finally, the final villain of Bleach is getting his flowers. Yuha is a character that's been in the game since 2018. However, since his initial introduction, no character prior to this has lived up to the hype and power that is, of course, the Quincy King himself. This Yuha not only having a very high damage output which gets further increased the more kills he gets, he also comes with really great utility with a built-in recharge between stages, and also most importantly, the first character in the game to get access to two soul bombs. And it's with that second soul bomb that not only allows him to clear content faster, but also sets him apart from any other character in the game. This, in my opinion, is a well-deserved award, and it feels good to finally have a Yuha that is actually playable in Bleach Brave Souls. That then takes us into our next award, the award for the best soul bomb animation. And within the year 2023, K-Lab easily stepped up their game, making some of the most impactful and impressive looking soul bombs in the entire game. Now, one of course main reason for that is due to the effects of the Thousand Year Blood War anime, where K-Lab were easily able to recreate the scenes and in some ways even made them better. For a game that's over 8 years old, this in my opinion is really impressive. And our next 6 nominees easily are the highlight of the entire year when it comes to best looking soul bomb animations. So with that said, let's have a look at the nominees. Here are your nominees for the best soul bomb animation for the year 2023. Ichigo Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version. Yuha Baha, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version. Ezno, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Yachiru, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. White, 8th Anniversary version. Ichigo, Renewed version. And the award for Best Soul Bomb Animation of the Year goes to White's 8th Anniversary version. Anniversary White now officially getting his second award for tonight's show. And man, how amazing does that soul bomb look? In just under 10 seconds, we can see the strength and also speed that comes with Anniversary White. Topped off with some really cool effects, this is easily one of the best soul bomb animations in the entire game. And we can say that about a lot of soul bombs released this year, but White officially is taking home the award for best soul bomb animation. And with that, that then takes us into our next award, the award for Best Resurrection. Because what we did see this year was an improvement when it comes to resurrections. Not only did we get back on track to having the good resurrection schedule of 6 characters getting resurrected in 1 month, we also saw these resurrectable characters pick up new skills, more skills, and also never before seen soul traits, making some resurrectable characters actually really exciting and once more fun to play upon resurrecting. And these 6 nominees that you're about to see easily highlight some of the best resurrectable characters of the entire year. Let's check them out. Here are your nominees for the Best Resurrection Award for the year 2023. Hikone, Confi on World version. Oetsu, Thousand Year Blood War version. Toshiro, Thousand Year Blood War Zombie version. Ichigo, 4th Anniversary Final Getter Potential version. Aizen, 1000 Year Blood War version. Soifon, 1000 Year Blood War version. And the award for Best Resurrection of the Year goes to Toshiro, Thousand Year Blood War Zombie version. I mean, who's really surprised? While we did get a great set of resurrectable characters, Zombie Toshiro easily stands out as one of the more usable resurrectable characters in the game. And it mainly comes from the fact that he's the only character in the year 2023, and still the only character in the game, to receive the SP boost upon resurrecting. With that, it allows him to hit significantly harder, and thanks to his soul train extra skills that he did pick up, he easily becomes a significantly more usable character. While he still doesn't hold a candle to the new characters released in the year 2023, he still is a really solid character, especially considering that he released over 4 years ago at this point. I think Toshiro set the standard of what Resurrection should be, and I think going forward in 2024, all Resurrections should strive to be similar or better than Zombie Toshiro. But moving away from resurrectable characters, let's have a look at the award for best artwork. And in my opinion, first impressions are everything. And when it comes to Bleach Brave Souls banners, the first thing you always see is the character's artwork. A good, well-drawn and detailed artwork can leave a lasting impact. And our next six nominees are easily demonstrations, examples of the talented artwork team over at K-Lab. So let's have a look at the next six nominees. Here are your nominees for the Best Artwork Award for the year 2023. Ichigo, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
俺が必ず何とかする。
Rukia, Japanese Parasol version.
雨上がりの世界は 美しいものだな。
Yachiru, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
ありとあらゆる刃と流派は私の手に。
Rangiku, 2023 swimsuit version.
一休みしたらまだまだ遊ぼうよ。
Macy, Burn the Witch Parasol version.
こういう衣装は初めてですけど、どうでしょう?
Bruno, Burn the Witch Parasol version.
こんな傘なら悪くねえな。
And the award for Best Artwork of the Year goes to Rukia, Japanese Parasol version.
雨の景色も悪くない。だが、雨上がりは格別だな。
Adorned in her elegant yet beautiful parasol outfit, the start of autumn, the sun coming down, the artwork itself is absolutely beautiful. While we had some really good artwork this year, I feel like Parasol Rukia, as most would seem to agree given the awards, is easily one of the best looking artworks in the entire game. It's hard to mess up Rukia, and Parasol characters had a lot of great artwork this year, but Rukia is easily standing at the top as one of the best pieces of art in Bleach Brave Souls. But artwork is one thing. Another great contributing factor to a character's appeal is the character design. How do their attacks look? How cool do they look? What exactly are they wearing? And that's exactly what we're here to highlight in our next award, the award for the best character design. This year saw a set of few original characters and also a lot of really cool looking yet stylish seasonal characters. And the award for best character design is easily going to go to the character that best represents how cool you can look with a unique outfit. So let's have a look at this year's nominees. Here are your nominees for the best character design award for the year 2023. Noelle, Burn the Witch Halloween version. Rukia, Japanese Parasol version.
だが、雨上がりは格別だな。
Rangiku, 2023 swimsuit version. Macy, Burn the Witch Parasol version. Bruno, Burn the Witch Parasol version. Ichigo, renewed version. And the award for Best Character Design of the Year goes to Bruno, Burn the Witch Parasol version. I mean, look at this character. Besides having also really impressive art, Bruno is just a good-looking character, easily one of Kubo's greatest. Put him in a parasol outfit and give him an ink motif, easily becomes one of the better looking characters in the entire game, especially with those glasses that he does have. It's a nice touch to it. And within the story that we did get for this collaboration, the story went that Bruno himself was actually a model. So was there anyone other than Bruno that really could win this award? Maybe not. But that then leads us into our next award, the award for most underrated character. In the year 2023, we had some really powerful yet exciting characters. Characters that are fun to play, but everyone's opinion is different. And some characters maybe didn't get enough love. Whether it was for one reason, maybe people were too harsh on the character. And these six nominees are the six characters that deserve more representation, deserve more love in the game. Maybe they're not as bad as the majority make them out to be. Does one flaw really ruin a character? I would say no. So let's have a look at our next nominees for the award of most underrated. Here are your nominees for the most underrated character award for the year 2023. Rukia in Japanese Power Sword version.
Daga, ame agari wa kakubetsu da na.
Ezno, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
Ubawareta bankai de todome o sasareru no wa.
Nini, Burn the Witch Halloween version.
Ah, kakubo shinasai. Odoroita?
Noel, Burn the Witch Halloween version.
いいものを見せてあげましょう。どうぞ。
Jojo, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Gin, Spirit Off Ever With You Untold Stories version.
じっくりやろうや。
なあ。
And the award for most underrated character of the year goes to Rukia, Japanese Parasol version.
だが。雨上がりは格別だな。
A character that maybe you don't think is underrated. Maybe this character already gets enough love in the game. But I can see where the audience have come from. Parasol Rukia, I think, is regarded as one of the better power characters in the game. However, having said that, she does have a few problems with the character. Maybe, like, me and some other players in the game focus too much on. Maybe the problems that she does have with her gameplay aren't that big of a deal in the large scheme of things. And it's now official that the Bleach Bracelet Awards highlight this character as the most underrated character of the entire year. But of course, with the fact that we can underrate characters, we can also potentially overrate characters. And these six nominees for the award of most overrated are characters that are not nearly as good as the public majority make them out to be. Whether you don't like their gameplay or you don't see the value this character does bring, there are many reasons to potentially overrate a character. So let's have a look at the six nominees. Here are your nominees for the most overrated character award for the year 2023. Ichigo, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version. Ichibei, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Ezno, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
Ubawareta bankai de todome o sasareru no wa.
Mini, Burn the Witch Halloween version.
Ah, 覚悟しなさい。驚いた?
Bambietta, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
これでも食ら
え! Ichigo, 8th Anniversary version.
俺自身の力で!
And the award for most overrated character of the year goes to...Bambietta, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Who would have thought this one was a surprise to me, but Bambietta, I can see where people are coming from. Bambietta having a very stationary kit, a unique kit, maybe not entirely everyone's cup of tea. So it entirely makes sense why this character was voted as the most overrated character of the year.I think everyone understands the value she does bring to her account, especially when it comes to the GeoQuest game mode, but I think not everyone really appreciates that or even cares about it. And that's entirely fair, we all play the game for many different reasons, but it seems like people don't really think Bambietta is as good as others make her out to be. But for our next award, we have the award for most fun to play. In this case, it's simple. Bleach Brave Souls is all about having fun, and these six nominees are the community's choice of the most fun to play characters. Whether that's using their strong attacks, using their normal attacks, having fun just looking at their soul bomb, there are many different ways to have fun in this game, and these six characters easily highlight the reason why we play Bleach Brave Souls. So without further ado, let's have a look at the six nominees for most fun to play character. Here are your nominees for the most fun to play character award for the year 2023. Ichigo, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.Yuha Baha, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
Warido.
Kilge, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Yachiru, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. White, 8th Anniversary version.Ichigo, 8th Anniversary version.
俺自身の力で!
And the award for most fun to play character of the year goes to... Yachiru, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
さあ、心ゆくまで。
I mean, who's surprised? Unohana is easily one of the highlights of the entire year. Unohana has history in this game, being one of the most impactful character releases back in 2018, now holding a similar title for the year 2023. Unohana encourages very fast and strategic gameplay with the use of a trap SA3 and most importantly, insane damage output. I mean, Frenzy Plus to with an 80% SP boost, and then also for the first time ever, the Rampage skill, it just makes this character an absolute beast to play, especially given how cool her visuals actually are. That Sobom is easily one of the best in the entire game. When you give us a character as badass as Yachiri Unohana with some really good strong attacks and visuals to back it up, I mean, how can this not be one of the more fun to play characters in the entire game? And speaking of fun to play, that leads us into our next award for favorite new character. Because in the year 2023, we did receive a new set of characters, first time playable ever in Bleach Brave Souls. And since we did receive so many new characters, this award highlights the new additions to the game, especially considering that we never thought some of these characters would ever be playable in the game Bleach Brave Souls. So with that said, let's have a look at the nominees. Here are your nominees for the Favorite New Character Award for the year 2023. Ezno, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Kyouge, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Eben, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Bogo and Asushi, Burn the Witch Parasol version. Macy, Burn the Witch Parasol version. And the award for favorite new character goes to Kyouge, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. I mean, Kyouge is easily once more another highlight of the year. Kyouge, just like in the manga and anime, set a great example for the future Quincy's and Stemwriters that have yet to come. With a high damage output, amazing strong attacks, unique abilities, and also some really impressive visuals to boot, how can you not enjoy playing as one of the coolest Quincy's in the game? And speaking of the game, of course, with Bleach Brave Souls, one large part of the game is not playing it, it's actually summoning. Summoning can bring a lot of excitement, but also at the same time, a lot of disappointment. And for our next award, we have the best summon quote. What quote did you just enjoy hearing when you first pulled them? And the award for best summon quote can go to the character that had the most memorable line, a line that extrudes their badassery, or just simply a funny quote. There can be many reasons for you to be excited for a quote, and these six nominees highlight that, as one of them will be put down as the best summon quote for the year 2023. Let's have a look at this year's nominees. Here are your nominees for the Favorite Summon Quote Award for the year 2023. Yuha Baha, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
この世界のすべては私が奪い去るためにあるのだ。
Ichibei, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
名もなき十字でわしを殺せると思うかね。
Ezno, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
視界の姿で自分の挽回に勝てるはずもない。
Yachiru, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version.
ありとあらゆる刃と流派は私の手に。
White, 8th Anniversary version. Ichigo, 8th Anniversary version.
感じるんだ。俺の力の全部を。
And the winner for Favorite Summon Quote Award goes to White, 8th Anniversary version. Which at this point is now his third award. I mean, how can you not like this character's quote? It's literally just him screaming. It also can serve as a jump scare, and it's sure to kick up your dopamine once you do officially pull him, especially if you are lucky enough to pull him during his release for the 8th anniversary. White is a badass character, and there's no better quote than him just screaming deep into your ears. And I'm sure for those that pulled him, were screaming alongside him. Speaking of screaming though, that leads us into our next award, the award for most anticipated character. While it's true we got some really exciting characters in the year 2023, we know, without a doubt, 2024 is going to bring even more exciting characters, especially since we're most likely going to get a lot of characters from Thousand Year Blood War Season 2. And while, to be fair, there's no guarantee a lot of these characters even get a new character this year, that still doesn't change the fact that we hope to see them within the year 2024. So let's have a look at the 6 nominees for the most anticipated character. Here are your nominees for the most anticipated character award for the year 2023. Rukia, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
見ろ、そして恐怖しろ。 これが本当の袖の白雪だ。
Kenpachi, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
さて、 一番強いのはドイツだ。
Aizen, Hogekyu Fusion version.
私はついに死神もホローも超越した存在となったのだ。
Ichigo, Final Getsuga Tensho version.
これが最後の月賀天章だ。
Yoruichi, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
あんな中途半端な気色悪い姿になど二度となるか。
Giselle, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
キャンディーちゃん、あの後継者君つまんでみたら。
And the winner for the most anticipated character of the year goes to Rukia, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
挽回、ハッカの咎め。これが私の残魄党の真の力だ。
Man, what a good year for Rukia fans, taking home 3 awards, in this case though, for the most anticipated character. I mean, it just makes sense. Bankai Rukia is easily one of the highlights of the Thousand Year Blood War arc, let alone Season 2 of the anime. A character that we've been following alongside since Episode 1, finally unleashing a Bankai, a beautiful Bankai, yet also a very powerful one. I myself am also included in the category of someone that is eagerly looking forward to the next Bankai Rukia, and I'm very excited to see how Caleb are going to make this character. I'm sure they're going to do an amazing job, just like Studio Perot did, adapting said Bankai in the anime. And with that, that then takes us into our next set of quickfire awards. In this case, the award for best update goes to version 15.3, which brought us battle power, more player ranks, and also revamping guild quests. The most anticipated update reward is now going to 10 times Soul Ticket and co-op. The award for best OST goes to Blades of Origins, the OST that we did get specifically made for the 8th anniversary. And the award for best trailer is also going to the 8th anniversary trailer. Some really cool stuff, but now let's have a look at our final 4 awards. Our next award is the award for the best banner. Because of course, in Brave Souls, one of the things that are sure to get you exciting, potentially disappointed, is summoning in banners. Now, lucky for us, in the year 2023, we saw a great increase of valued banners. No longer are we getting the 7-step formats. Finally, we have a pity system where you're guaranteed the character that you want in a certain amount of steps. Never before have I ever wanted to pull on so many banners within the year 2023. And in this case, our next 6 nominees easily highlight some of the banners that I almost went down to 0 on. I think every banner nominated here, I myself at least did 25 steps. And I'm sure many of you watching at home probably did the same thing. So let's have a look at the 6 nominees for the Best Banner Awards. Here are your nominees for the Best Banner Award for the year 2023. New Year Special, Thousand Year Blood War Zenith Summons Unveil.
Breach. Brave Souls.
Thousand Year Blood War Zenith Summons Invasion.
Zendan Meichu.
Post Election 2023 Step Up Summons.
Breach. Brave Souls.
Thousand Year Blood War Summons Desolation.
Breach. Brave Souls.
8th Anniversary Step Up Summons.
Breach. Brave Souls.
Burn the Witch Collaboration Summons Japanese Parasol Chick.
Breach. Brave Souls.
And the award for Best Banner of the Year goes to New Year Special, Thousand Year Blood War Zenith Summons Unveil. Ichigo, Yuha, and also Orihime, a 50-step banner. Never before have we seen a banner go that far, while at the same time also bringing us 3 really exciting characters. Ichigo and Yuha easily being some of the more anticipated characters for the end-of-year celebration, while at the same time we go on Orihime to ensure that if you owned her, you would absolutely dominate Brave Battles. The value is there for these 3 characters, the fillers were great this time around, and finally we got a banner that wasn't just 7 steps and done. This Thousand Year Blood War End of Year Special easily highlights how good potential banners can be in the future, since we're no longer getting 7 steps, and we also potentially can have some better valued Thousand Year Blood War filler. But unfortunately, not all banners are the same. And our next award, the award for Worst Banner, are banners that, you know what, gave us time to save, so it wasn't all that bad. But at the same time, these banners just really weren't worth summoning on. for many reasons. Whether the characters themselves weren't exciting enough, whether the characters weren't good enough, or at the same time, maybe the filler pool was absolutely atrocious. So let's have a look at the 6 nominees that highlight some of the worst banners of the entire year. Here are your nominees for the Worst Banner of the Year award for the year 2023. Aranka Crown Summons, Ruthless Warriors.
Breach, Brave Swords.
The Lost Agent Summons, Shades of the Bonds.
Breach, Brave Swords.
Aranka Summons, Trez Antagonistus.
Breach, Brave Swords.
Waco Mundo Summons, Trez Seafras.
Fair na tatakai o shiyou janai ka.
Soul Reaper Academy Summons, Vigor.
Breach, Brave Swords.
Aranka Summons, Reverence.
Breach, Brave Swords.
And the award for Worst Banner of the Year goes to Aranka Summons, Reverence.
その一撃がノイトラ様に届くことなどありはしない。
I mean, who pulled on this? Who pulled on this banner? It was a mid-month. The character traits themselves weren't that exciting. And the characters themselves weren't entirely too bad, but probably not really needed. Definitely forgettable characters, and at the same time, given that Abirama was there, also brought a lot of outrage, considering that Abirama got 2 characters in 1 year, and there are plenty of other characters that are still underrepresented in the game. This was overall a very easy skip, and gave us more time to save orbs for the better banners. But just like these banners weren't worth summoning on, our next award is to highlight the characters that just weren't simply worth even using. Because our next award, the award for Worst Character of the Year, is to highlight characters that almost brought you no value. Maybe made you question, what were K-Lab even thinking? Were they even trying with these characters? Whether it was bland visuals, terrible artwork, strong attacks that you would never think would be used in 2024, these next 6 nominees highlight some of the worst that we saw within the year 2023. Here are your nominees for the Worst Character of the Year award for the year 2023. Zamari. Yami. Zyapro, the hidden version. Noitora, the hidden version. Izuru, sorry for Academy version. Liliane, Fierce Battle version. And the award for the Worst Character of the Year goes to Izuru, Soul Reaper Academy version. I mean, talk about a character that brought almost no value to your account. Sure, Izuru himself did have a 30% droplet soul trait, but other than that, the character played like a 2020 character. For a character released in 2024, that's kind of atrocious. Bland visuals, okay strong attacks, but most importantly, terrible damage output. Frenzy plus 1 and a 40% Berserker? Even for a mid-month, that is almost unacceptable. Even in the year 2023. But lucky for us Bleach Brave Souls players, while there are always going to be those sets of terrible characters, there are also going to be characters that you just have to get your hands on. And our next award, the award for Best Character of the Year, is going to highlight the character that stood out the most within the year 2023. Whether they were limited, premium, this is a character you almost wanted to get your hands on. Whether that was because they had great visuals, good strong attacks, or most importantly, great damage output, these were characters that you sure didn't want to miss. So without further ado, let's highlight the last award for the night, the award for Best Character. Here are your nominees for the Best Character of the Year award for the year 2023. Ichigo, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version. Yuha Baha, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version.
Warido.
Kilgay, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. Yachiru, Thousand Year Blood War 2023 version. White, 8th Anniversary version. Ichigo, 8th Anniversary version. And the award for the Best Character of the Year goes to Yuha Baha, Thousand Year Blood War 2024 version. I mean, we've already spoken about the character already when he won the award for Best Limited Character, but man, is Yuha such a powerhouse, especially in the year 2023. Great set of strong attacks, unrivaled damage, and most importantly, getting access to two soul bombs makes him a powerhouse and great character in any game mode you put him against. Future characters will be compared to him, and I must say how great it is that the best character in the game is a Mind character. Mind at the start of 2023 was in a terrible state, and since then, we received some great additions. So much so that the award for best limited and premium character both went to Mind characters. So if there was any attribute to receive the most love this year, it was definitely the Mind attribute. And here's hoping the power attribute receives a similar treatment in the year 2024. But with that, unfortunately, our award show comes to a close. The year 2023 was a great year for Brave Souls. We finally started to get more Thousand Year Blood War characters, and the quality of said characters also got further increased. We saw easily some of the best looking characters in the entire game, and some of the most effort put into characters, whether they were seasonal, premium, or Thousand Year Blood War. Being part of this community while new character releases were easily some of the best parts of the year, and even outside of character releases, we received some of the best updates this year, getting new game modes, revamping game modes, new quality of life that would make us want to play the game more with the battle power and new player ranks. There was a lot to do in the year 2023, and once more, I'm eagerly looking forward to what the year 2024 is going to bring. So with that, I'm the BBS World Champ, hope you enjoyed tonight's show, and I'll see you all next year for the Bleach Brave Soul Awards for the year 2024. Take care. Alright, another year, another award show. Luckily this time around we had better security, so we didn't have to worry about anyone invading our show like the last 2 years. Alright, let's pack things up.
It's a 強化水月を使っていないと錯覚していた。